anytime you can speak in front of people, record yourself so you can see what went well, what didn't go well, okay? So that's exactly what I'm doing. So basically, I moved to Atlanta. I ended up starting a media company called RNG Media. So I film television shows, I film movies, I currently do that. But what happened was, sometimes in life, your gifts will make room for you. Your gifts will make room for you. So how it worked out in my life was, I was going on these red carpet events. And when I heard about the opportunity to teach at Spelman College, I said, they won't hire me. I'm young. I've never been a professor before, right? All of these doubts. But guess what I had to do? I had to step out of my own way. Remember this, you miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. You miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. So I took the shot, I went into that office in front of Dr. Miller. And always remember this, success is when preparation meets opportunity. What is success? Let's try that again. Success is what? That's right. Success is when preparation meets opportunity. When I walked in that office for that interview, was I prepared? I was. I had my master's already. But did the opportunity line up? It surely did. When those two things came together, I landed. You know what helped me get the job? When I showed Dr. Nelly all of my videos of me interviewing people on the red carpet, interviewing Ice Cube and Snoop Dogg and Terrence Howard, Lisa Ray, when they saw me interviewing all of these celebrities, it made me a perfect fit for public speaking. So a lot of times, I shared that with you to say a lot of times the things that you are doing, you don't know how it will line up with your future goals and future career, but all things, all of your gifts will make room for you, okay? We're gonna snap that up too, All right, any questions about me before I move forward? No questions, let's keep it going then. I want y'all to take a good look at this. All right, here's what I want you to do. I want you to close your left eye. And I want you to focus on the plus. Close your, some of you may not be able to do this because of your angle. Close your left eye and focus on the plus. And when you move your head slightly, what should happen is that circle should disappear. It may work better for some than others. Only focus on the plus. Cover your left eye and focus on the plus. And then you can do the same thing with your right eye. Close your right eye and focus only on the circle, and the plus should disappear. Give y'all a second to play with that. Some of y'all didn't work. It's not going to work for everybody because your angles that you had. Did it work for anybody? Didn't work? No. It worked for you? So it's true, right? So it worked for one person in here. The point, what I was trying to show you with this example is proof that your eye has a blind spot. I mean, I'm like, this is not anatomy. What are you doing with this, right? Your eye has a blind spot. So basically what happens in vision is that when you see an image, anything that you see, the light rays that you see, it goes through your eye. It goes through the optic nerve and it sends a message to the back of your brain of an image of what you are seeing. Now, understand that we all have a blind spot in each one of our eyes. It's a fact. Please look it up when you can. My point is, anybody ever been in a car? And it's a car on the right side of you, and you're about to get over into that lane, and maybe your friend on the passenger side is like, oh, it's a car right there. But you couldn't see it, right? Why? It was in your blind spot. But think about this. Your passenger was in a different position, and they could actually see what was in your blind spot. And my point is, since each one of us have a blind spot, there are going to be some things in your life that are in your blind spot that you can't see. There are going to be some things, some issues that you can't see. But too many of us make inferences as we talk about critical thinking. Too many of us make a determination on things that we can't see, and we expect a logical judgment or a decision. All right, so think about that since we all have this blind spot, right? This is so important. This is why you need good friends. You really need good friends or good co-workers or somebody who loves you to point out the things that are in your blind spot that you cannot see. Y'all get that? You gotta have somebody around to point those things out. Now, what is consciousness? Being mindful or being aware of something, right? Do you know that if you are not conscious of something, you can't hardly see it? Where does consciousness live? Where does consciousness live? In your brain. So basically, you can only see as big as your perspective. Think about that. You can only see as big as your perspective, the things that you know, the things that you have learned, or as we talk about critical thinking, the questions that you've asked, the information that you've received, right? The facts, right? And then you can make a logical judgment on something. So now that you understand that consciousness lives in your brain, think about what Albert Einstein said. Albert Einstein said that blind belief to authority is the biggest enemy of freedom. I'll say it again. Blind belief to authority is the biggest enemy of freedom. What I'm trying to tell you is too many of us don't think for ourselves. You let someone else tell you what to think without asking appropriate questions. We just accept what authority figure says. But you know what you should be doing? Study, asking questions, and show yourself approved. Show that you know. Right? So you can come to a logical decision. So always remember this as I conclude with my blind spot point. The mind, I'm going to say the eyes are useless. The eyes are useless when the mind is blind. Got that? Just remember that. Keep that in mind. Let's move forward to the presentation. I think y'all will hear some more music though. Let's get into it. First of all, what is critical thinking? Somebody tell me. And when you speak in here, please make sure that you stand up and project. Or I'll come around and give you the mic. What is critical thinking?
All right, any guesses? Somebody want to break the two words down?
Critical thinking.
I see y'all critically thinking about that question. Anybody? Going once.
Okay, there we go. Thank you, brave soul. Basically breaking down a thought so that it can be comprehended and explained to other people. I love that example. Any other answers for critical thinking? Anybody else? Let's look at what the dictionary tells us critical thinking is. Critical thinking, and that's excuses, I don't know why it's looking like this, but it looks a little weird. Critical thinking is that mode of thinking about any subject, content, or problem, in which the thinker improves the quality of his or her thinking by skillfully analyzing, assessing, and reconstructing it. So you must skillfully analyze first. Then you must assess the problem, then you reconstruct it in your mind. Critical thinking is self-directed, it is self-disciplined, self-monitored, and is self-correcting thinking. I love that part, self-correcting thinking. It presumes assists and rigorous standards of excellence and mindful command of the use. All right, has anybody in here had to do some self-correcting before, unless it's just me? Anybody else? Would anybody want to share any situation that you had to where you actually had to defend a belief or a request or a behavior, and how you're able to support yourself. Anybody can think of any situation that you're going through where you had to defend something. Anything? Nobody. Okay. We will move on from that then. But just think that critical thinking is self-correcting. So a lot of times you have to analyze things. You have to analyze yourself and your biases so that you can come up with a logical conclusion. Now, being a good critical thinker, it means that you consistently search for the truth. The truth is out there. You have to search for it diligently, okay? You have to find out what the truth is. Next, to be a good critical thinker, it means that your job is to seek out and to be guided by knowledge and evidence that should fit with your reality. Too many people jump to conclusions. Anybody guilty of that beside me? Jumping to conclusions without analyzing first, right? Without getting all of the facts. And if you're a lawyer, you will know sometimes people may use he said, she said, right? Which is called what? Hearsay. And people use hearsay as fact. And they use that to jump to their conclusions without doing what first? Without critically thinking. Always, always think for yourself. Always. All right. Even if it goes against our cherished beliefs. Whoa, what does that mean? What do you mean, think for myself, even if it goes against my beliefs? What are we saying here? What are we saying? Yes.
Basically, how I think that as is being unbiased to a situation or an issue or a problem, although you might feel some type of way about a certain situation, the best to do it in terms of critically thinking and being analytical is to kind of see it from two sides at the same point in order to move forward, I guess, with the truth and a better, in a different way.
I love that answer. There was a couple of things that you stated that were absolutely spot on. That were absolutely spot on. You got to look at it from both sides of the coin, right? Not just your side, right? Too many people do that. Let's say if you're making an argument and you're pro-life, right? You're making an argument against pro-choice. Too many people will tell you all the facts about pro-life and won't even tell you anything about pro-choice. They don't even know that side. Right? They don't even bring it into consideration into their judgment. And another thing that you said that was so key, I'm trying to put my finger back on it, it was the bias. Do y'all know what bias is? Just throw it out. What is a bias? It's a what? It's a judgment. Now, what kind of judgment are we talking about? Maybe a negative one. You may have a bias about other people, or you may have a bias about what? It's a preconception. We all have our own biases. The problem is our biases help to form our judgments and our conclusions because of our own personal bias. Personal bias. I may have a personal bias that's stopping me from thinking about something. If it's a relationship, I can't think clearly about the relationship because of my personal involvement. So I come from a biased perspective. Y'all get it? So those are things you always must analyze your own personal bias to come to a logical conclusion. Skepticism is not a bad thing. You ever heard somebody say, you're a skeptic? You ever heard people say that? It's okay. Be a skeptic. All it means is that you are reserving judgment. A smart person knows when to speak and when not to speak. When to think first. Think before you speak, right? So skepticism is not necessarily indiscriminate rejection of ideas. Somebody says something, you're not immediately rejecting it because you're skeptical of what they're saying, but what you are doing, you may be doubting or suspending your judgment until you have analyzed the situation, right? You have deepened your own understanding of it. You've evaluated. You've looked for your own biases. Once you have done those things, then you can stand on a logical decision. So being a skeptic is, guess what? It is quite okay. Don't worry about that. All right, inference. What is an inference? Anybody? What do you think an inference is? Somebody make an educated guess. You hear it all the time. What is an inference? Stand up from here, you loud and clear. Anybody else want to take a guess? This is critical thinking. It's okay to think today, okay? It's okay to have a wrong answer, okay? Nobody's judging anyone here. So it's quite okay. What is an inference? Anybody want to make a good guess? You got something? I see other things like that. What do you?
Sister.
to become a good critical thinker, you must deepen your understanding of the problem. Period. Oh, I wish I heard that when I was in high school. Oh, I wish I heard that when I was younger in college. Deepen your understanding. Until you just go and cut the girl and find out his cousin or somebody else related. You don't know. There is not enough information to form a logical conclusion in this sentence. Now let's look at this sentence, shall we?
Today, I'm going to teach you a tactic before the end of this class
that if you apply it to every situation, even if you're upset and not logically thinking, I'm going to show you something to where it forces you to think correctly, or at least forces you to evaluate the situation properly. And if y'all remember this for the rest of your life, you're going to be so much better off, I promise, okay? But I'm going to save it for last. You're like, you want it now, huh? You want it now. All right, so what I want to do now is I want to break you up into groups. Good thing you are already broken up into groups. I want to, since y'all are thinking, since your minds are fired up, I have some thinking questions for you. And we're going to find out who's the best table, who's the smartest, what table is the bad supercritical thinkers, okay? I mean bad in a good way, okay? All right, so you have a question that I'm going to pull up. You will only get a minute and 30 seconds to come up with the answer as a group. Write your answer down on a piece of paper. Okay, so I know, like, if you hear the right answer from another group, you didn't change your answer, okay? So we'll just say y'all group 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So put your group numbers on the paper. So once the timer goes off, I'll come by and pick up, you know, just make sure you have your paper down with your number on it. And we're gonna see how your critical thinking skills are, okay? We'll let y'all get y'all paper and stuff together. Meditate if you need to. Here it is. If a plane crashes on the border between U.S. and Canada, where would the survivors be buried?
You have 24 seconds left.